What do you want them to understand?
That I love you guys. I'm not gonna hurt you guys anymore, I promise.
Well, you have to understand it's gonna take time.
I know, I understand that. I'm not pressing that. You guys just being here for me right now.
Yes.
That's good enough. But I love you guys.
Love you too.
I love you.
You know, there's that old adage that time heals all wounds, and I just don't believe that. I mean, it's not the passage of time, it's what you do with that time. And one of the things that I've picked up real clearly here is that you guys say, this just came out of the blue. Actually, it didn't come out of the blue. She has been chronically depressed for a long, long time. And I think she's had a lot of suicidal ideation. And at no time did she ever make a declaration about this. At no time through this did she ever get any treatment until finally it rears its ugly head. And what people do when it finally gets to the point they can't take it is they do what's called dissociation, where they just pull out. And you say she looked down, looked back up, and it was a completely different person?
Yes.
That's called dissociation.
I'll never forget that look.
But in that moment, they are a different person with a different value system, with a different yardstick of measuring right versus wrong. And I'm not saying the murder was predictable, but I'm telling you the break, the snap was predictable. By the time she is folded back into this family unit, I don't think you are going to have to be afraid that something's going to come out of the blue. And the other point I want to make, I think sometimes we really have to understand that you don't have to love everything somebody does to love that person. What she did was a hateful thing. And I told her straight up, depressed, not depressed, whatever. She did not have the right to make the decision to end her mother's life that night.